Mask on breathing device is a trainer that allows air crew to experience hypoxia. And the reason for that is because if the oxygen system was to fail at altitude, they would want to be able to recognize their own personal symptoms and then realize they need to take action to save themselves and save the jet. When the student sits down, they're experiencing what they would see in the cockpit. We wanted to have a trainer that would be mimicking what you would do in your day-to-day situation. So for them, using a flight simulator is their working environment. So while they're in their simulated flight experience, we are getting them slowly hypoxic.
So we started out below 10,000, nice normal breathing on a mask. And as it creeps up and you get over that 10,000 threshold, you really start to feel some of those hypoxia symptoms.
The onset of hypoxia can be subtle, or for some people it can be quite sudden. So being able to recognize how that affects you individually is important for the safety of the air crew.
One of the main things that we normally see is the first onset of hypoxia is air hunger. Generally like a heavier breathing pattern, something outside of their normal range. From there it could be a plethora of different options.
For me, euphoria was the first thing that came on. As we kept climbing up, tunnel vision starts coming on. Those hot flashes come on. You can feel your fingertips start getting really cold. That was my real indicator. All right, it's time for oxygen.
As a person starts to verbalize their symptoms, we can put that on a timeline and give them that feedback in the post-flight scenario so that they can remember that a little bit better and take action sooner if it wasn't an actual in-flight emergency.
I'm giving them real-time data about what they may be able to experience for hypoxic training. We need to go in and make sure that they can identify their own hypoxic symptoms in a real-life scenario to prevent any loss of life or damage to vehicles.
It's a very good tool because it shows you not only your onset rate, but at your 10,000 threshold, once you start going up, it shows as the student starts calling out those symptoms. That kind of gives you also an early warning of what your hypoxia is setting in. It shows your breathing rate, shows your heart rate. It really shows you when everything's starting to come on.
This is the third generation of a breathing trainer. We used to call it the reduced oxygen breathing device, and that had two generations to it. That included compressed gases. We were feeding our students nitrogen to get them originally hypoxic, and because of that, we had the need to purchase compressed gases, and that became a financial burden, as you can imagine. With this new system, it's an on-demand flow, which mimics the OBOG system, or the onboard oxygen generating system, which does not require the use of compressed gases. We use ionized water to get the same hypoxic experience that we had with the legacy systems. And so the pilots can now focus on the training, getting hypoxic and experiencing their own symptoms, but getting it in the same mannerism that they would experience in the actual jet.
For the air crew side, it definitely gives you the ability to identify it before in a safe environment, by identifying it when you're actually out in the air. But it gives you the tools that you need to have a safe flight.